Hello friends, today I am creating a video on the different types of overheads. Generally, मैंने देखा है बच्चों लोगों को ये problem होती है. They are not able to understand what is the difference between budgeted overheads, actual overheads and absorbed overheads. So let us take a small example and understand the difference between these type of overheads. Let us say I am making these markers. I have a company who's making this markers. In my company, for simplicity purpose, let us say there is only one type of overhead, which is electricity. So I have only one indirect expense, which is electricity. Now let us start thinking ki electricity expense mera kitna lagega in the coming year. So I'm standing on day one. And I am trying to calculate, I am trying to estimate what will be my electricity expense for the coming year. So I decide that I am going to have an expense of rupees 500 per month. And for 12 months, so my expense is going to be rupees 6000. Beta, ye maine kab kiya? I did this on day one of the year. When I'm doing this on day one of the year, matlab mera actual expense nahi hua. This is what I have just thought. This is what I have just estimated. This is known as budgeted overheads. This is budgeted overheads. Now, again on day one, I think that, okay, this is my expense. Main kitna produce karne wali hu? How many markers am I going to produce in the coming year? That also I estimate. So, I estimate that I am going to make, let us say, 1000 of these markers in the coming year. So, my budgeted output is going to be 1000 markers. Now, we all know that this 6000 rupees burden has to be given to whom? These 1000 markers. So, that is why I distribute rupees 6000 among these 1000 markers and I get a rate of rupees 6 per unit. Ye kya hai? This is absorption rate, also known as recovery rate. Ye kya kiya maine? Total budgeted overheads ko divide kiya kisse? Budgeted output se to get my absorption rate. Beta, ek baar ye mil gaya na, isko utha ke seedha dustbin mein fek do. We don't need this anywhere else. Budgeted overheads is out of the picture at all. We don't need this ever. Ek baar ye nikal gaya, our work with budgeted overheads is over. Isko utha ke dustbin mein fek do. Theek hai ma'am, fek diya. Aage badhte hain. Now coming to the end of the year. Ab end of the year mein kya hua? End of the year mein mere paas actual figures aa gaye. I know what I have done in the year. So, I got all the actual figures means I got what is my actual overhead. Actual overhead kya ho gaya? Actual overhead means how much I have spent from my pocket. Ye pocket se kitna paisa chala gaya? That is my actual overheads. Jo asli mein kharcha hua hai, the expense, the actual expense, the actual money which has gone out of my pocket is my actual overheads. So, let us say at the end of the year, my actual overheads came up to rupees 7500. This is my actual expense. Will I also know the actual output? Yes, obviously. I have produced for the whole year. I know actually how many units I have produced. So, I have actual output also. Let us say my actual output is 1100 markers. So now I have 1100 markers with me, which I have produced, and the actual overheads is 7500. हम लोग दो overheads already cover कर चुके हैं. What? Budgeted overheads, with the help of which we calculate the absorption rate. Now this is of no use. Please throw it into the dustbin. The other thing that I have is the actual overheads, means the actual spending from my pocket. So we have covered two overheads. अब एक main overhead रह गया, that is our absorbed overheads. तो मैम absorbed overheads क्या होता है? Let us see. Once I started with this absorption rate, day one में मेरे को पता था that each unit I need to recover rupees 6. तो let us say I price the marker at rupees 30, in which 6 rupees is the absorption of overheads. मतलब overheads is equal to rupees 6. एक marker बनाया, उसको 6 rupees से tag किया. दूसरा marker बनाया, 6 rupees से tag किया. So in these 1100 markers, I have tagged each one with 6 rupees. Either this year or next year or whenever I am going to sell these 1100 units, when I am going to sell these 1100 units, how much money with respect to overheads am I going to get back in my pocket? I am going to get rupees 6600. Kaise? 1100 markers into my absorption rate of rupees 6. So what is going to come back to my pocket? Rupees 6600 is the money that is going to come back to my pocket. This is absorbed overheads. This is absorbed overheads. So absorbed overheads kya hua? Absorbed overheads means the actual base into the absorption rate. Ma'am, actual base kya hota hai? I wrote actual base because here we, for simplicity, we have taken that we have divided it by 1000 units. Sometimes the absorption rate is also on the basis of hours or on the basis of any other cost. For example, you would have seen in some of the cost sheet mein likha rehta hai factory overheads, 30% of direct wages. What is that? That 30% of direct wages is also an absorption rate. So in case it is on any other cost or on the basis of hours, you will have to take actual hours or actual cost. So jis pe bhi absorption rate hai, if it is per unit, you have to take the actual units. If it is per hour, you'll have to take actual hours. If it is per percentage of some cost, you'll have to take the actual cost. For example, material cost, labor cost, etc. So this is my absorbed overheads. A beta, last point. Ma'am, where are these recorded? Beta, isko to dustbin mein utha ke fek diya tha. This is not going to be recorded anywhere. This is not going to come in my books at all. Budgeted overheads, I am not going to record. Bache do overheads, actual overheads and absorbed overheads. Absorbed overheads will always come in my cost sheet. हम लोग जब भी cost sheet बनाते हैं, we never record the actual overheads. We always record the absorbed overheads. आपने देखा होगा, again I am repeating, cost sheet में लिखा रहता है factory overheads 30% of direct wages, 100% of direct material. ये क्या है? ये absorbed overheads है. Cost sheet में हमेशा absorbed overheads आएगा. And actual overheads कहाँ आता है? In your financial records, what you record is your actual overheads. Financial books जो होती हैं, उसमें हमेशा actual आएगा और cost sheet में हमेशा absorbed overheads आएगा. With this, we can connect one more topic. कि मैम, under और over absorption क्या होता है? Under और over absorption is very simple. मेरे pocket से कितना गया? Actual overheads. मेरे pocket से गया 7500. What has come back to my pocket? Rupees 6600 has come back to my pocket. Now, gone 7500 and coming back 6600. Kya hua? Did I absorb more or did I absorb less? Obviously, I absorbed less. I paid 7500 and what I got back is 6600. So, beta, I have an under absorption of 7500 minus 6600. 600, that is equal to rupees 900 under absorbed. अब इसी जगह दूसरा एग्जांपल लेते हैं. लेट अस से माय एक्चुअल आउटपुट इज नॉट 1100 मार्कर्स, लेट अस से इट इज 1500 मार्कर्स. नाउ इफ आई प्रोड्यूस 1500 मार्कर्स, अगेन 1500 मार्कर्स, ईच वन ऑफ दीज मार्कर्स आर टैग्ड विद रुपीज 6. सो हाउ मच इज कमिंग बैक टू माई पॉकेट? आई एम गेटिंग रुपीज 9000 इन माई पॉकेट. कैसे? 1500 मार्कर्स इंटू the absorption rate of rupees 6, that is rupees 9000 coming back to my pocket. 9000 coming to my pocket, what is going out of my pocket is 7500. Zyada absorb kiya ya kam kiya? Zyada kiya. Kitna zyada kiya? 9000 minus 7500 rupees 1500 over absorbed. 1500 over absorbed. So we can say that under and over absorption is the difference between which two overheads? Between actual overheads and absorbed overheads. Beta, dimag mein rakhna, budgeted kabhi nahi aayega. Budgeted overheads ka kaam khatam ho gaya once we have calculated the absorption rate. So this is the concept of budgeted overheads, actual overheads and absorbed overheads. Plus, how do we calculate the under and over absorption? Thank you.